I'm Deanna Williams. I am CEO of Influence Entertainment, a veteran broadcaster, and a lover of Frankie Beverly. Frankie Beverly's music has had an enormous impact on specifically Black culture and global culture as well, because he has traveled the world many times over. But he is one of the crisp, clear, clarion voices of the experience of being Black in America and in this world. It's as simple as that. Song titles, song lyrics, for instance, "We Are One." What an optimistic, positive anthem. He's an anthem creator. Joy and Pain. When I think of Joy and Pain, I think of the realities of what Black people have endured in this country. We know about the pain, we know about the struggles, but we also are triumphant. We know about succeeding despite adversities. And for me, Frankie Beverly's music is an articulation of those things that Black people have experienced, are experiencing, and will continue to do so moving forward. Frankie Beverly is a Philadelphian. He was born and raised in this community. And so, despite the fact that he moved to Southern California, it didn't matter to us in Philadelphia, because we were like, this is where you're from always. And I know that people in DC think and feel that he's from DC. People in New Orleans, I lived in New Orleans 20 years. You would have to get into a knife fight with some people in New Orleans, because they will tell you that Frankie is from New Orleans. And where did they get that from? Well, he did a live album in New Orleans. And for some reason, it's fixed the mentality of lots of New Orleanians that he's from there. Wow. So you've got DC, you got Baltimore, you got all these other cities claiming him. But the reality is that he is a native son of the city of brotherly love and sisterly affection, Philadelphia. Frankie Beverly, in the scope of Black music and history and music, period, reigns supreme as one of the architects of soul and silky soul. To quote one of his songs, Silky Soul Singer, and that was a song that he was doing for Marvin Gaye, who was one of his mentors. But he is probably one of the most underrated artists in Black music, but one of the most consequential at the same time. It's a dichotomy that he finds himself in. If you have ever gone to a Frankie Beverly and Mays concert before a primarily Black audience, you are gonna see people just raise up off the ground with bliss, who know every lyric to every song. And even if they've gone and seen that show, that same show, over and over again, it matters not, because the elevation, the spirituality, the vibrations are so high when you go to a Frankie Beverly show. You can set your watch to the good energy that you're gonna get. When I think of Frankie Beverly, I think of the Grateful Dead and Jerry Garcia. In the rock world, they are gods and very revered. But Frankie Beverly, oh my goodness, he is a god. And there, of course, there is one god, but he is so godlike and so revered and appreciated by audiences that go to see him perform. Frankie Beverly did not cross over to white audiences or other audiences as much as he was entrenched in the Black community, because what he does is so Black, and so Black to the point where white people couldn't understand that level of soulfulness. in my opinion. But I think that the lane that Frankie Beverly created for himself was so distinctly rooted in Black traditions that white people just couldn't get the totality and the messaging. I mean, can you get out of a Black house party and not hear Before I Let Go? When Beyoncé recorded Before I Let Go and put her contemporary spin, the Beehive went crazy, and so did everybody else. And I thought it was a fitting homage to one of our beloveds. Thought it was a wonderful moment. And again, it cemented his place in our hearts when we party, when we suffer, when we fall out of love, when we argue, everything. The lyrics, if we just look at the body of the lyrics of Frankie Beverly, they describe us from the moment we wake up, brush our teeth, wash our face, get dressed, go out into this world, have to function and deal with other people. Literally, he has given us the blueprint, musically, for living lives in America and this world. Asking me what is my favorite Frankie Beverly song is like asking me which of my three children is my favorite, but I can tell you several of them. I love Golden Time of Day, Southern Girl. I mean, there's so many. It's hard to pick one. And it really depends on what mood that I'm in. But forever and always, Joy and Pain. I have played that song on the radio my entire career. And it never gets old. The whole body of work. And rain, would you do it by yourself? Thank you, Beverly.
Yeah.
I adore you. And as a radio personality who's been on the airwaves for 50 years, I have played all your music, deep cuts, not just the singles. I listen to your music when I am home, in my car, in the shower, everywhere. You are the soundtrack to my very experience as a human being, as a Black woman. And I am grateful to you for the abundance that you have given us. So grateful. Thank you, Frankie Beverly. You are a superstar.